We all know the Southern rock band Alabama, founded by Randy Owen and his cousins Teddy Gentry and Jeff Cook in the 70s. They have over 40 number one hits, and 21 of those hits were achieved consecutively. They've received over 200 awards from various organizations, and we all know the songs. Mountain Music, Dixieland Delight, Roll On 18 Wheeler, Southern Star, High Cotton, 40 Hour Week for a Living. If you're going to play in Texas, you got to have a fiddle in the band. I'm in a Hurry and Don't Know Why. And those are just the ones that I can name off the top of my head right now in this moment. And despite the near constant chatter about Alabama, the greatest and most popular band ever, no one talks about fake Alabama. Wait, you've never heard about fake Alabama? Well, let me be the one to introduce you to the well-forgotten group Atlanta.
Singing sweet country music, breathing clean mountain air.
Your ears don't deceive you. That is a band knocking off Alabama's signature harmony style, using a similar instrumentation, a similar logo, and the name of a different place that begins and ends with the letter A. Now, you don't have to be a rocket surgeon to figure this one out. Despite Atlanta releasing almost 10 singles, only the first three went anywhere. So let's constrain this conversation to analyzing their first three singles, because they're also the only ones with individual Wikipedia entries. Atlanta's third single from 1984 is called Sweet Country Music. It's a song that talks about family and Southern values, exemplified by the act of singing sweet country music. Compare and contrast that chorus to the chorus of Alabama's 1982 hit, Mountain Music, released 2 years earlier, a song about, you guessed it, family and Southern values exemplified by the act of playing mountain music.
Oh, play me some mountain music.
You got it!
Like Grandma and Grandpa used to play. Then I'll float on down the river to Kansas.
Oh, how I wish that is where the similarities ended. But you might notice that both tracks also start with a harmonica solo. Both songs also feature a driving bass drum behind the mostly a cappella chorus, a classic Alabama move that you'll recognize from other hits like Roll On 18 Wheeler.
Sweet country music, breathing clean now. Roll on highway, roll on along, roll on.
At least it's not like both songs end with the band kicking into double time, while a fiddle break just erupts on top of everything. Because that's like an Alabama staple. They do that in like multiple hits. Wait, you're not telling me for real? Here's the thing, you can copy all of the tropes of Alabama, but there is one thing that no one would be brave enough to do like Alabama, and that is the senseless pandering to the working class. Like at the end of a 40-hour week for a living, when Alabama ends the song by playing America the Beautiful. Surely no band would be so brave as to just insert a classic American song in the middle of another song just for the feels, like Alabama does. Again? Seriously?
Will the circle be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by?
By and by.
Okay, so we're dealing with a real copycat act here. I think we can all agree on that. In fact, they've included so many Alabama cliches that I can't even compare this to just one Alabama song. It's like an unholy amalgamation of all the things Alabama is known for. And we let that song get to number 5 on the Billboard country charts. We did this. We welcomed it into our home, and we invited it to stay around. It's another dream of Dixie. Dixie dreaming is all I do. It's the memories that keep me Dixie dreaming. Atlanta's second single, Dixie Dreamin', is slightly less egregious, arguably because they had less time to really hone in the copycat act. See, Dixieland Delight by Alabama came out in January of 1983, while Atlanta's Dixie Dreamin' came out in September of the same year. But beyond the de-alliteration and the inclusion of the word Dixie, they admittedly don't have a ton in common. See, Alabama's Dixieland Delight is a song about a loved one that relates the relationship back to the hook of Dixieland Delight, while Atlanta's Dixie Dreamin' is a song about a loved one that relates the relationship back to the hook of Dixie Dreamin'. Oh, wait, that's the same thing again, isn't it? Spend my dollar, park in a holler, need to mount a moonlight. Hold her up tight, make a little loving, a little turn of dovin' on a Mason-Dixon night. It's my life, oh so right, my Dixieland delight. Now, one thing that Alabama is universally known for is the ability to jam chorus after chorus down your ear holes without you noticing. For instance, Alabama's 1982 hit came at the peak of Alabama honing in on its ability to reduce songs down to just the chorus. Though the song is only 2 minutes and 48 seconds long, the chorus is sung 7 times. 7 times. Now, Atlanta never had the opportunity to hone those skills, so we will forgive them for only singing the chorus of Dixie Dreamin' a meager 5 times over the song's 3 minute and 46 second runtime. You heard that right. They had an entire extra minute to work with, and they fell 2 choruses short of the undisputed country music world record set by Alabama. Embarrassing. I'm in a hurry to get things done. I rush until that's no fun. All I really gotta do is live and die, but I'm in a hurry and don't know why. I'm in a hurry to get things done, Lord. Rushing, rushing till that's no fun. All I really gotta do is live and die, but I'm in a hurry and don't know why. I'm in a hurry to get things done, Lord. Rushing, rushing till that's no fun. All I really gotta do is live and die, but I'm in a hurry and don't know why. Atlanta's first single, which we haven't really talked about yet, doesn't really sound like Alabama, mostly because it's about a 30-year-old woman putting the moves on a teenager. She was over 30, he was barely 17. Yikes. Sounds like she's guilty of love in the first degree. I'm guilty of love in the first degree. That's an Alabama joke. No, but seriously, this song makes me super uncomfortable. Almost as uncomfortable as the moment in the Oak Ridge Boys' 1978 single, Call 'Em Baton Rouge, when they say, a strange combination of a woman and a child. That's a teenager. You're stopping every 20 miles to call a teenager. Shame on you, Oak Ridge Boys. And shame on you, Garth Brooks, for covering the song. Newgrass Revival, you're cool. I'm all right with you. But most of all, shame on Atlanta for thinking that no one would ever notice that some of their songs sound kind of like another band. God, I feel like I gotta go for a drive just so I can stop thinking about Atlanta. Hey, how about you, Alabama?